Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we are going to continue our table in Substance Painter. For that I have exported my table model in FBX format. So let's import our model in Substance. So press Ctrl N to take a new document. Go to File, Select and select your FBX file. I'm going to take the resolution to 2K, but you can take 4K, 1K, whatever you want. Let's take 2K and press OK. Now our table is imported. So what are we gonna do first is that we're going to bake our texture maps. For that I'm going in texture set settings, go to bake mesh map, deselect the ID and thickness because we're not gonna use that. Go to output size and select 2K. And I'm going to use the anti-aliasing 4x4 and select bake selected texture. Now our textures are baked. So we're going to start with taking a material. I'm going to use a smart material I found on Substance website. This is a free of cost material you can use. I'll be dropping the link of this material in the description. So let's just select and drop. Let's open this material and find the paint, and in the paint I'm going to decrease the roughness a little bit because I want my paint to be a little shiny. So let's decrease the roughness to, let's say 0.4. And change the color of your choice. Now to add some custom paint peel effect, let's select a paint color mask and add a new paint layer. Go to brushes and select the dirt brush. And start making some paint peel effect. So make your brush very small and keep your floor to 100% and spacing to 5. Increase the size of the brush and make more damage effect. Just paint randomly on the corner, on the edges, until you see a perfectly damaged wood table. To create the paint peel on the edges of these drawers, make your brush very small and go to your UV view, select one point, press shift to make a straight line. Do the same for all the edges on the drawers. Now we need to add some dirt on this table. So for that I'm going to take a fill layer and disable all the layers except color and roughness. So disable metal, normal and height. Increase roughness to 1 and take the base color. Let's just keep the base color as it is for now. And I'm going to take a mask and select the dirt cavity and drop this on our dirt layer. Now adjust the mask according to your need. Just go to the mask builder and play with level and contrast. Let's decrease the level for 0.15 and contrast to 0.6. Now when you're done with level and contrast and the other parameters of your dirt layer, now you can change the color. So I'm going to make it a little darker and go to the opacity here and decrease it just a little bit. Again, open the mask builder and increase the level to 0.25. Now again take another fill layer and do the same for this one. Deactivate the metal, normal and height. Keep the roughness to 1 and drop your dirt dusty on this layer. Now decrease the opacity and change the color. Now we are done with our table, so let's paint our drawer knobs. So go to the texture set list and select the metal. Go to layers and smart materials and drop the bronze armor. Now our knobs look a little bit shiny, so go to the base metal and decrease the metalness to 0.9. and roughness to 0.5. Now our smart material for the knobs already contains some damaged and rust, so I don't think we need to add any rust or scratch on this, so I'm going to leave it as it is. Now our table texturing is done. You can export the textures and render this in Marmoset toolbag. So thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.